A few days back, I had released a video on how to use the filter function. In that video, I had mentioned that filter function can be more useful than pivot tables as it auto-refreshes data. One of our viewers, Ravi Iyer, liked that video and left wonderful comments appreciating the content. A big thank you to Ravi for that. In addition to his feedback, he had requested if I can show a comparison between the filter and the pivot table. This video is on Ravi's request and shows exactly that. The data that we have here is a representation of what talent acquisition or the recruitment teams in an organization maintain. This is a simplified version of some work that I had done with the HR team of an online retail company. They had similar data and the team manager would view the status every few hours. The manager wanted to see two views. Application by status. Example, all application with status as open or selected or rejected. Count of applications in those status for each recruiter. So to enable those views, the team had applied filters on the data and the manager would apply filters to see all applications by a particular status. So for example, if he wanted to see all application with open status, he would filter on status and select open and then see all the applications. However, the challenge was if the status was updated, then the filters needed to be refreshed. If I change the status of the last candidate to selected, then I'll have to refresh the status of the filters to take the name out from this list. This is not automatic or dynamic. Let me change the status back to open for the last candidate. For displaying the count, they used a pivot table. Let me create one and show you. Select the data. Go to the Insert tab and click on Pivot Table. Press OK. In rows, I will add the name of the recruiter. In values, count of applicant number. And I'll add the status in filters so that we can filter on the selected applications. And we have the count here. Again, if I update the status of an application, these counts won't change. I will need to manually refresh. Alex's selected application count is 1. I will once again change the data for the applicant in the last row. From open, I will make it as selected. As I come back to the pivot table, the data does not update from 1 to 2. I have to manually refresh every time to check for any updates. Right click and refresh. Now the count changes to 2. This manual refresh was often a point of contention and confusion with the manager. To resolve this, we use the filter function for both the solutions. Let's start one by one. I'm going to write status here in cell E1. Also, create a dropdown in cell F1 with 3 values: open, selected, rejected. I'm going to copy the header from the table. And paste it in the cell starting E8. In the cell E9, I will write a simple filter function. Filter. The first parameter is array, where I will select the entire data from our table A2 to D16. Fix the reference. For the criteria, we need to provide the filter condition. The condition is the status is selected or the value in cell F1. So I will select D2 to D16, fix the reference, and check if it is equal to cell F1. Fix the reference. Let me select the status selected in cell F1. We have our result. I'm now going to write a sort around the filter. I won't provide any other parameter, and by default, it will sort ascending on the first column. As you can see, the names are now in ascending order. We have the data for 8 rows, which matches the count in the pivot table. Now if I go and change the status of the last candidate back to open, and come back to this table created by filter, the number of rows reduced to 7. So with filter, it automatically updates the table, and I don't have to update or refresh the filters. However, the pivot continues to show the count as 8. And if I refresh the pivot table, the count changes to 7. As you can see, filter table makes this more dynamic. Now let's look at the solution for the counts. In cell E3, I will write a simple unique function to get all the names. For array, I will provide the list of all the names in A2 to A16. I will sort the data. Now, before we move forward, let me do a little bit of formatting. Now we need to calculate the count of selected candidates. For that, I will copy the filter function that we have written here and paste it in cell J9. I will change the array from A2 to D16 to A2 to A16. This will only give me the names of recruiters for whom the applications are in selected status. We can use this list to calculate the count of each recruiter. Now in the cell F3, I will write a COUNTFS formula. COUNTFS. For criteria range, I will select J9, the first cell for the dynamic array output, and then press hash. This, as you can see, will include all the names irrespective of how many the filter function returns. Similarly, for criteria, I will select E3 and press hash. That's it. I have the count which matches the count in the pivot table. The difference is that these counts are dynamic. The count of selected applications for Alex is 1. If I go and update the status of the application in the last row to selected, the count in this table created by the filter function increases to 2, and we also have the entry appear in the table below. The pivot table continues to show 7 until I manually refresh it. It shows 8 only after that. So this is how filter function makes the whole thing dynamic and saves you time and prevents potential errors that you may make in case you forget to refresh the data. Thanks, Ravi, for asking this question. Hope this video was helpful to you. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in another video.